Getting set for first pitch from Safeco Field. Royals and Mariners, next. Now from Safeco Field in Seattle, MLB The Show is on the air. Ought to be a good one here between the Kansas City Royals and the Mariners. Welcome in to Mariners Baseball here on the show. Matt Vasgersian here with you. More from the guys as the night moves along, but first, let's take a look at the starting lineup for our visitors here, the Kansas City Royals, as Ned Yost has his guys lined up like this. They'll tee it up against a surprise third-place finisher in the 2013 AL Cy Young Award balloting, the Japanese-born right-hander Hisashi Iwakuma. Norichka Aoki will move towards the batter's box as we're just about set to get underway tonight. And a high chopper. Throw just does beat him to the bag, as that was pretty close. So Aoki unable to get on here to open things, and with that, let's take a look at the defense for the Seattle Mariners. It's brought to us by Majestic. If it happens in baseball, it happens in Majestic. Omar Infante will be the batter. Here it comes now to Infante. And he lays off there, 1-0. And 0 to be on the beach in Hawaii tonight. 43 degrees at first pitch. Off the plate again, and it's 2-0. And that's over, 2-1. That's in there above the belt, so it's even now, 2-2. Here's a ball hit foul down the third baseline, so they'll try it again. Swung on, and a fair ball rolled weakly up the line at first. And he'll take it onto the bag himself. Two gone now here in the first. Eric Hosmer will get his first shot here. And you can see he's got that average up near the 330 mark to begin play. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Two out, nobody on. And that misses, 1-1. And just lucky to make contact on that one as it's chopped foul. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Now here's the pitch. And he gets around on one and hits it high and deep to straightaway right. And that'll get down for what should be extra bases. And he'll round it and try for third. And the throw in gets away from him. Fortunately, however, the third baseman's able to run it down, so there's going to be no advance. Wow.
You know, guys, I thought when this ball left his bat that it had a good shot to get out of here. A picture-perfect swing, but you'll see this ball bang off the top of the wall, and then they're just a little bit slow out there retrieving this thing and getting it back to the infield. So he's going to take advantage of that and coast around second and into third with three bases.
Billy Butler will dig in, and this season certainly hasn't been all that kind to him as he enters play with the average down in the 230s. And a fastball is in there for strike one.
All of a sudden, you got to be careful now with the cleanup guy up there with a runner in scoring position. He could be in danger of giving up that first run after all.
Now a ball lined to the right side. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
Yeah, that's a good job right there with two away to pick up the first run of the ball game from third base. Very important to cash in when you're given the early opportunities, and he comes through big time right there.
Alex Gordon will try and keep things going now with a runner at first following the RBI single. A little late on the slider here as he hits it the other way to third. He'll flip it over to Cano at second, and that'll be that. It's a run on two hits here for KC. We'll move on to the bottom half of inning number one. It's the Royals 1 and the Mariners coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the... There's the starting lineup for the host Mariners. Abraham Almonte will step in now to lead things off in the home half
leading
of the first.
The Mariner, center fielder, Abraham Almonte.
Cut fastball in there for a called strike. Now here's a fastball from Shields. Hit on the ground for the shortstop, Escobar. On to first is Escobar, one away. Dustin Ackley will dig in here. First pitch on the way. Now a ball swung on and taken the opposite way out toward fairly deep left center. And there to take it in is Gordon for out number two.
Well, three pitches, two outs here to start the home first. He's got to be loving that.
Second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Robinson Cano will get his first cuts now, and he'll do so with the bases empty and two away here in the first. Cano waits on the first pitch. Right down Broadway that time, strike one.
Yeah, showing no fear there. He put the pitch right at the letters away, but that guy didn't want any part of it.
And this is swung on and lifted down the left field line, but it'll get back into the crowd as he jumps ahead of him now, 0-2. And he reaches for one but can't find it as he's down on strikes for the final out. 1-2-3 go the Mariners. They're down 1-0. Salvador Perez leads things off now in the top half of the second.
Catcher, Salvador Perez.
Now here's the first pitch. And over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. And this ball will be chopped foul. And here's a big swing as he sends this one in the air out toward deep center. And it's a fly out to start the second, one away.
Yeah, once the sun goes down here, this place plays like a much different ballpark. Case in point right there. That ball had no carry whatsoever.
So one away here with the bases empty. And standing in, the left-handed hitting third baseman, Mike Moustakas. Open stance by Moustakas, and now the pitch. And he lays off a pitch here that he probably shouldn't have, 0-1.
And if you're not careful, this is the kind of guy that can run off six scoreless innings against you from here out. So that first inning run isn't something you can bank on holding up.
And he takes a pitch high and away for ball one. And he'll try to hold back the swing, but he'll do so unsuccessfully as that's ruled a strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a swing and a miss, he struck him out, and it's two up, two down to start the second.
Well, let's check the grip on that last split-fingered pitch. You can see how wide his fingers get across the top of the baseball, and that's what gives it the backspin needed to be effective.
Lorenzo Cain will get his first shot here, and he certainly had it working so far this season, up over 350 entering play. And this will be fouled away. Now a swing and a ground ball to third. And he's got himself a base hit.
Well, he needed a hit like this. Got to get him to snap out of this cold streak. I mean, you're just looking for something to go your way. And that ball, it's not hit particularly well, but it happens to find a hole. He's saying, man, it's about time.
Alcides Escobar is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. Up top, it's 2-0. And with two away here, this is not the time to lose the strike zone.
Especially not to a number nine hitter. The last thing you want to do is turn this lineup over and give these guys a shot to make something out of this inning after all.
And a split-fingered pitch catches the zone 2-2 now. And now this ball's lifted in the air down the right field line, but this will get back into the seats, so the count holds at 2-2. Now a slider in the dirt. Good block by the catcher there.
And now 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
Here's a ground ball to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One hit, one left. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Royals 1, and the Mariners nothing. Corey Hart will start things off in the bottom of the second.
For the Mariners, designated hitter, Corey Hart.
Shields jumps ahead here with a good fastball for strike one. Now here's a ground ball that'll get by the mound and into center field for a leadoff single. Kyle Seager will stand in for the first time here. Changeup called strike one.
And he's probably not going to throw too many first pitch changeups. That's a pretty darn good call.
Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
Just overmatched him there.
Come on, Mariners.
A liner caught at third by Moustakas. And that's a loud out number one.
Well, that's a late swing here on a fastball, but he still squares it up pretty good. If he gets this thing just a little higher, this might be two bases. Instead, it's just right into the third baseman's glove.
Justin Smoak comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one.
Here we go, Justin.
Here's a swing and a ball lined over the head of Infante and into right center field for a base hit. And he'll make it over to third base safely, so that puts runners at the corners with only one gone.
Well, that is just picture perfect right there. You know as a hitter that you're going to want to make sure you hit it to the right side to get that runner to third base. But if you do it well enough, you get yourself a base hit to go along with it. Check it out. He lets this pitch get almost past him, but then he manages to still get good contact and send it into right field for the base hit.
Michael Saunders will get his first opportunity here, and that average is certainly not where he wants it, down in the 220s to begin the ball game. In there, strike one. Now a swing and an easy ground ball to first. There's one. On to first, but not in time. He beats it out to keep the inning alive, and the run is in to score.
Yeah, really, no shot at two on a high chopper like that one. They do wind up getting the force at second, but that runner from third is able to just waltz in and score.
Mike Zunino will get his first cuts here with two gone now and a runner at first. Pitch on its way now to Zunino. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one.
And he's probably a little bit upset with himself for giving up that early run, but he really reached back for something extra right there.
And the 0-1 is lifted in the air out to right. And Aoki will put this one away to retire the side. A run on two hits, and they leave one. We played two full, all tied at 1-1. Norichka Aoki is ready to go here as we begin the third.
Right fielder, Norichka Aoki.
And he'll start the inning with a pitch that misses off the plate. It's ball one. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. One away here to begin the third. Omar Infante will stand in. He grounded out his first time.
Omar Infante.
Now a ball hit foul off to the right and up into the crowd. Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2. Swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes. So it's two up, two down to begin the third.
If you want to see a guy get blown away at the plate, this is just one finger down three times in a row. He was just overmatched there.
So bases are empty here with two gone. And standing in, here's the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0.
And if he can get himself into a fastball count, don't be surprised if he has a big cut at something. Maybe try and break this tie ball game.
A little over anxious that time as it's a ball and a strike. Swing and a ball sliced foul into the seats down the left field line. Bases are empty here with two men out. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. That's on the ground to short. This should end the inning. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Casey down in. Brad Miller will stand in now. Still struggling to get anything going offensively. Opposite field to left, but he'll hardly need to move out there in left as this is hauled in for the first out.
And that's one of those plays where you might need to reinforce the laces on your glove after this inning ends. This is a fastball, and it is hammered. I mean smoked. But he ends up with nothing, and his average is going to go down.
Abraham Almonte will dig in again. He grounded out to start the home first. Good off-speed pitch there from Shields. It's 0-1. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now. Just a touch outside, 1-2.
Jeez, finally. That's the first ball they've taken all night. About time, boys.
And a swing and a miss as they caught him reaching that time, and there are two away. Dustin Ackley will try it again. He flew out his first time. And he gets ahead 0-1.
And even with two outs, this is a team that can still put something together here, especially in this part of the lineup. So you can't let your guard down.
And now this is swung on and lifted in the air to left center. And Gordon will make the catch to retire the side. Mariners are down in order. Through three complete, all tied one apiece. Billy Butler will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
The designated hitter, Billy Butler.
Fastball that gets the inside corner, strike one. And here's a fastball called for strike two. And this is taken there by Butler. It's a ball and two strikes.
Yeah, with the bases empty, that's a right spot for that 0-2 pitch. Make him see if he'll chase that slider.
Slider, but that's low as it's dug out by the catcher there. Now the 2-2 pitch. And Butler swings and misses. He's down on strikes for out number one. So one away now for Alex Gordon. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one.
Come on up.
Swing and a miss for strike one. Now a swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2.
You can tell he's got sinker on the mind because he definitely undercut that one.
To two balls and two strikes now. One run on three hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. And this is a strike three call. Oh, caught a break there. Two away. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And you can see there both guys getting it up into the 90s, 92 and 94 respectively. Salvador Perez will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. And a curveball to begin the at-bat, 0-1.
Boy, his control has been outstanding so far. And there's another pitch right on the black.
And a curveball that he didn't get on top of there. It's 1-1. Now a ball pulled hard but fouled off to the left. Swing and a liner. And that'll get down for a two-out single. And some trouble now in right field. Mike Moustakas will stride in again. He struck out swinging his first time.
Mike Moustakas.
And he starts him out with a splitter for a called strike. And he gets a piece of it here, but it's chopped foul. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Fouled back. He'll try again, 1-2. And a sinker there, swung on and missed for out number three. Robinson Cano will lead things off here in the home half of the fourth.
Second baseman, Robinson Cano.
Now a ball lined hard toward deep right field. Aoki is there and he has it for the out.
First pitch swinging here to start the inning, and he didn't waste any time waiting for his pitch. He got it right there. Just hit it right at somebody.
Corey Hart will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. In there for strike one. That's on the inside corner to put him behind here, nothing in two.
And I'll tell you, being in a two-strike hole is not the spot you want to be in against a guy like this.
Now here's a ball hit sharply toward the right side, and Hart has himself a base hit. Kyle Seager will stand in, a line-out victim his first time. First pitch coming. He's running toward second. Pitch outside. The throw. And this will be in time as Hart will be caught stealing here at second. Oh, much too tardy on the fastball. 1-1. Swing and a grounder fouled off to the left. And this one's tapped foul at home plate. Another 1-2 delivery. And he comes back with a fastball. Strike three called, and the inning is over. Lorenzo Cain will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Center fielder, Lorenzo Cain.
First pitch to him. And he holds up here, but the pitch is a cold strike anyway.
He's just cruising out there now.
I'll tell you, this may turn into a game of first team to two wins.
And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1. Ball bounced foul over near the longtime infielder and current third base coach Dale Swaim. The right-hander deals on 1-2. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting into foul territory now toward the third base dugout. We'll back up and put this one away just past the dugout for the first out. Alcides Escobar will stand in. He grounded out his first time. There's a good fastball on the outside corner as you'll take a look at strike one. And he just gets a piece there as this is chopped foul. And did he hold up in time? A look down, and yes, he went around. It's strike three.
We'll take a look at the reaction here and show motion, and you can see him immediately go to first and say, oh yeah, he went around. Sure enough, he got the answer he was hoping for.
Norichka Aoki will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second, and indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Justin Smoke will be the one that leads things off when we return. Home half of the fifth. And there is Justin Smoke now. He'll start things out here in a tie ball game.
First baseman, Justin Smoke.
And here's one that misses to the leadoff man in the inning. The number six hitter in the lineup. It's ball one. The pitch count there. One pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
And here's a ball hit in the air. There to pull it in is Hosmer, and there's your first out. Michael Saunders will stand in. He reached on a fielder's choice his first time. Lined hard to center field. Kane is there now, and he has it, two gone. Mike Zunino will dig in here. He flew out his first time around. Swing and a ball hit foul, as this will find the seats in right. Swing and a miss, and he's in trouble now, 0-2.
Boy, he is putting on a clinic out there right now. These guys don't know what to look for.
Lifted down the line in right and back out of play. Count holds it 0-2. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. And this one runs in on him as he can't get his arms extended. A great pitch there. Omar Infante will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Omar Infante.
Yoervis Medina will get the call here as he'll start the sixth inning on the mound.
31, Yoervis Medina.
Omar Infante will get things started here in the top of inning number six. 4-1.
Omar Infante.
Pitch to the plate is a slider for a strike, and it's all knotted up at 1-1. Now a fastball that just misses here as the count moves to 2-1. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. And this is going to be fouled into the diamond level seats. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
And he's having a rough go of it so far. His second strikeout of the ballgame. You can see him gesturing that he thinks that pitch was outside, but you know, I think once he gets a look at it in the clubhouse, he'll probably change his tune.
Eric Hosmer is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1.
That thing's coming in there hot. 96 miles an hour.
Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1.
Tough pitch right there. That's 96 in on the hands. You just got to let that one go.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And now a pitch on the way. And he's fallen behind now, 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
Gets him to swing and miss there, 3-2.
Well, this is turning into a real dogfight now.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch-outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
I'd say he's made a pretty good impression since coming on. Two batters, two strikeouts to start the inning.
Billy Butler will stand in now. He's singled and struck out in two trips. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
And guys, this has been just what the doctor ordered out of the bullpen.
Yeah, they needed him to come in and give him a strong inning, and he's done exactly that.
Come on in.
And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now another 1-2. Oh, and he rips this one to first. But a good play by the first baseman to spear this one, and that'll retire the side. Royals go down 1-2-3. Still tied one apiece. Brad Miller will be the batter as we get things going in the bottom of the sixth.
The shortstop, Brad Miller.
And he gets on top of this one and sends it on the ground to short. Throw on to first, and one shortstop grounds out to the other, one away. Abraham Almonte will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Swing and a ball hit to the left side, and this is going to wind up a souvenir. Swing and a hard ground ball to third. In time to first, and there are two away. Dustin Ackley will stand in again. He's flown out in each of his first two plate appearances thus far. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. Not the first time he's felt the squeeze tonight.
Yeah, he's looking and saying, what do I got to do to get a strike?
And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
This is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count. And that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
3-0 now.
And you know, he's been the beneficiary of most of the calls here tonight, but I think that's one that he thought he should have had.
And that misses as well. Ball four, so it's a four-pitch walk here.
And he's saying, give me a break. I mean, that pitch is right there. And I tell you, though, complaining like that is only going to squeeze that strike zone a little more.
Robinson Cano will dig in now. He's struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats. And a cut fastball, but this bounces near the plate for a ball.
Well, not really how you want to start the next guy after a walk. That pitch isn't even close.
Now a ball lined to the left side. Foul. Runner aboard at first here with two gone in a 1-1 ball game.
Come on!
Changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it. 1-2 now. Might want to stay away from that pitch in the foreseeable future.
Yeah, whatever that was, he's lucky to get another chance.
And a pretty feeble effort that time as this is tapped in front of the mound. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends. Alex Gordon will lead it off here in the top of inning number 7. Now the first pitch.
Gordon.
And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. This man out for a second inning of work, and why not? He set him down 1-2-3 the last time around.
Right, and with two strikeouts mixed in there as well. Just let him keep going.
And the seventh inning starts with a flyout here, one away. Salvador Perez will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far. Now a check swing, but it's strike one anyway, says the home plate umpire. Here's a swing and a ground ball, but this will get foul for strike two. And that's swung on and fouled straight back. And a swing and a miss here, so it's a quick two outs to start the seventh.
Since coming in the sixth, he's knocked down five in a row. It's giving him a real lift out there.
Mike Moustakas is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. A little bit outside, 2-1.
A much better approach here at the plate so far. He's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
Right on the corner, 2-2. Full count now, 3-2.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Bouncing ball back up the middle. And a bit of a high throw that time, but not much problem over there at first. Is that Corey Hart will stand in to lead off the inning. Middle third of the lineup, 4, 5, and 6 as they try to get something going.
And this whole lineup's been pretty quiet all game long. Just the one run, that's it.
And Shields starts the at-bat with a changeup, good for strike one.
And this isn't the first guy that's been frozen by that pitch tonight. He's had a lot of guys shaking their heads so far.
That's in there as well. It's a quick 0-2 count.
Boy, I'll tell you, to be down 0-2 against a guy like this with the stuff he's got tonight, not a comfortable spot to be in.
Throw is not in time, and a great job of legging that out as now the go-ahead run is on base to lead off the inning. Kyle Seager will stand in again. He lined out his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time up. Oh, and it froze him, and they got him. Here's the first offering. This is swung on and popped up, crossing into foul territory now behind third. And that's going to land foul. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as he's behind 0-2 now. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning. Justin Smoke will stand in. He singled and popped out in his first two at-bats. That hits the outside corner. It's strike one. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second, taken by Infante. On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. One hit in the inning, but no one left. We'll look ahead to inning number 8 now, all tied. Lorenzo Cain will stand in now to lead things off, and he'll do so with the same pitcher still out there. Seems he's earned himself another inning.
I think that's a definite vote of confidence, but he's done a nice job since coming in, so you might as well ride that hot hand.
Well hit, but also well fouled into the seats and left. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. The 1-2 offering looked like a slider that time, but it's 2-2.
Yeah, that's a great pitch on 1-2. Start it in the zone, and hopefully you'll get that guy thinking he needs to protect. Turned out to be a good take.
Now a sharply hit ball back up the middle, and that's going to be a base hit, so a good start as the possible go-ahead run is aboard to start the eighth.
You talk about getting the bat head out in front. This is rifled up the middle. Can't square up a baseball any better than that.
Alcides Escobar is in for the third time now as he takes a called strike. It's 0-1. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. And a pitch out. Nothing doing, though, and that's ball one. Fouled back. And this is fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul. And he just does manage to fight this one off as it's fouled away. Go-ahead runs aboard here at first with nobody out. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Norichka Aoki will stand in. They've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-3 thus far. Runner goes. Pitch is high. The throw. It's high at the bag, and that's not going to be in time, so the go-ahead run moves into scoring position now on the stolen base. Swung on and rolled towards first. And he'll take this one to the bag for the out, but meanwhile, the runner will move up 90 feet to third base. Omar Infante will step in now in a big spot here in a game as close as this one.
He had a chance at redemption, too, because he hasn't done much through his first three plate appearances. And he can make up for all of that with a base hit right here.
To 2-0 now as he hits with a runner at third and two away. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
Now that he's worked it to 3-0, he's got a couple of free pitches here to pick out one he really likes.
And he missed with it there, ball four. It's a two-out walk with the runner still at third. Eric Hosmer will stand in with a showdown looming. Two on, two out here in inning number eight. One run, five hits, and no errors so far for the Royals. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike.
And here's one of those times where the Royals have to start finding two hits.
Hard hit towards center. Almonte is there now to put this one away for the third out as they'll strand that potential go-ahead run at third base. Royals strand a pair. Score remains. Jared Dyson will stay in the ballgame as he takes over in center. Michael Saunders will lead things off here in the bottom half of inning number eight. They set the target in, and this finds the inside corner for strike one.
Yeah, he probably won't have too big a dip in velocity the rest of the way. But the later this game goes, the more important it'll be to watch where his location is. That's probably the bigger concern.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. Mike Zunino will stand in now. He flew out in his first time around and then was a strikeout victim last time. Late on the fastball there as this one skied out towards straightaway right. Aoki is there, two down. Brad Miller will step in. He's lined out and grounded out in two trips. Now this is swung on, and here's another fly ball out to right field. Aoki is there, and it's a very quick inning as the side. Billy Butler will stand in, needing to get things started here in the top of the ninth.
Designated hitter, Billy Butler.
Tom Wilhelmsen will enter now to start the ninth inning as his job will be keeping the game tied until the bottom half. Billy Butler will stand in, needing to get things started here in the top of the ninth. Right field on a base hit, so a great start to the ninth as the possible go-ahead run is aboard to kick off the inning. Alex Gordon will stand in with the go-ahead run at first, so he'll need to at least get him into scoring position with nobody out. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. And down in the Mariner bullpen, it looks like a right-hander's up to throw. Good curveball. Strike two.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
Inside, as he might be trying to set him up here, one and two. Fastball, and he turns on one, sending it high and deep to right. And this ball is gone. A home run that gives them the lead here in the ninth inning. A two-run shot here for Alex Gordon, and it's given the Royals a 3-1 lead. Number 52 is on, and he'll take over on the mound.
Number 52.
Salvador Perez will be the first one to greet him as he'll start fresh here with the bases empty following the home run. Good hard sinker swung on and missed, 0-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Mike Moustakas will try again, 0-3 thus far. And he hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one. That's taken. Now it's 0-2. And look out as that one ran in and got him. Jared Dyson will get his first opportunity now. The cutter runs outside, ball one.
Pretty good speed here coming out of that left-handed batter's box, so it's no sure thing that a ground ball means a double play.
And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Now he just did everything right here on the mound. He made the good pitch. He got his guy to hit the ball on the ground. But baseball's just a little bit like life. You know, things don't always go your way. This is going to be an infield single as he reaches here with one away.
Here's a fastball at the knees. Good spot, good pitch. And it's 0-2. Grounded, foul. And here's a ball rolled foul. Still two strikes. Swing and a line drive to left. And he won't get it as that's down for a base hit. And they'll quickly get it in here to hold that runner at third base. Norichka Aoki will stand in now in what could be one of the bigger at-bats of the ball game.
And what he has to do right here is put his 0-for-4 out of his mind. He hasn't had the greatest of performances to this point in the game, but he could make up for it with a big hit right here. Boy, that's just a nice pitch right there with the bases loaded. He gets an infield fly out of it for a big second out, and now he's given himself a much better chance to get out of this mess.
Almonte is there, and he puts it away as they're able to escape with only limited damage on the scoreboard. The Royals come up with a pair, however, on this two-run home run. Last chance coming up for the Mariners. It's now 3-1 KC. Abraham Almonte will start it off here in their half of the ninth, and no sign of a reliever. They're going to let him try to finish this one off.
Well, he's been brilliant so far, so why not see if he can take it the distance? It just doesn't happen these days very often.
And here's a swing and a ball lifted in the air into fairly deep center field. Dyson is there, and that won't help the cause. It's a quick out here to start the home ninth. Dustin Ackley will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. And he takes a pitch that's ruled a strike at the knees. Pretty liberal strike zone there. It's 0-1. For that man right there, just the one run allowed. The question is, can he make that lead stand up?
Well, he hasn't shown too many signs of cracking so far. He's got the look of someone right now who's ready to go the distance.
Now a swing and a ground ball, but this will wind up foul. Still 0-2. Now a swing and a little bouncer softly hit to the right side of the mound. Throw on to first, and the Mariners are now down to their final out. Robinson Cano will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of
throw on to first, and the ball game is over.
Well, we talked about how they needed a good outing out of this guy, and he gave them that and even more, finishing off the complete game victory.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. And guys, the Royals were led to victory by the start turned in by this man, James Shields. Don't put that card in your bicycle spokes. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, just the one run allowed, but anytime you can give your bullpen a day off, it does nothing but help your club in the long run.
So that'll just about do it. For Eric Harrow, Steve Lyons, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. This has been a presentation of MLB The Show. For more, don't forget to check out theshownation.com. The Royals come out on top, 3-1. Good night from Seattle.
Mariners, one run, four hits, no errors. They left 2 men on base. The winning pitcher is James Shields. His record is now 5-3. The loss goes to Tom Wilhelmsen. He falls to 0-2. Time of the ballgame, 2 hours and 39 minutes. A reminder that extra postgame trains will be available at the King Street Station, located just north of Safeco Field. Metro Transit buses are also available at stations on 1st Avenue, Royal Brom Way, and Edgar Martinez Drive.